Hey, this is Ur. I hope you are great. In this video, we will check how we can implement a sign-in with GitHub feature. As a quick demo, I click on this button and I have now a consent screen. Authorize this app and it will redirect me to our app. And now I'm logged in, as you can see. So it is that easy. I can sign out and sign in with GitHub like this. Okay, let's go and learn how we can do that. First of all, I would like to talk about this repository. I have opened this repository for only username password started, but then I decided to add other authentication methods as well, such as email verification. After this video, I will open another branch here so that you can reach Google Sign-In and GitHub Sign-In implementations as well. So I will put this link into description so you can definitely check it out. And if you find it helpful, you can give it a star. First thing we will do is creating a new app in GitHub. We can do it by going settings and scroll down. You will see developer settings. Here you will click new GitHub app and you can give it a name. I will say Lucia GitHub out. We must give a homepage URL. Let's call it localhost 3000. Enter our callback URL, which will be API out GitHub. That's fine. And it asks for webhook. We don't need that. And we will click any account here. And for the permissions, we will click on account. And we want to access user email address. And be sure that you select read only. That's it. That's the only thing we need here. So we can create a new GitHub app. Registration successful. This is our client ID. So I will copy this ID and go to my application. Go to my env file. I will add GitHub client ID here and paste my ID. And then here you can see client secret section. Click on generate a new client secret. Here is our client secret. I will copy it and paste it in my env file. And we are done. Perfect. So as for the codes, I will actually copy the codes from the implementation we made for Google sign-in. And it's because we will do the same thing over and over again, and I don't want to make this video so long, but I will try to explain everything you need. For the schema, we have a user table and OAuth account table. This is where we store access token and user ID provider. Provider, for example, can be Google, GitHub. So that's why we created a new table in our database. It's because we want to support multiple providers. Yeah, in the user table, we have profile picture, URL, and name here. Perfect. So what I will do is go to sign in form. Here you can see we have a sign in with Google button. Copy this and paste it here so that we can see two button appears. And I will change it to GitHub. When this button has clicked, we will call a function. I will copy this as well and change it to on GitHub sign in clicked. And we don't have a server action yet, but we will create in a bit. So I will call it create GitHub authorization URL. We are doing the same thing. We will create an authorization URL and we will redirect user to that URL. And let me copy this and paste it in on click. Now I will go to .actions. This is where we define our create Google authorization URL. And I will paste the same function and change the Google into GitHub. And now I can import it in the sign-in form. So error is gone. We will modify this function a bit. In Google sign-in, we need to have a code verifier, but for GitHub, we don't need a code verifier. I will remove this from the function. All right, so we are generating a state. This is a random string actually. So that comes from Arctic, as you can see. We are using Arctic for handling out operations. And after generating this state, we are storing that state in our cookies because we want to validate this state later. And in authorization, we will call GitHub. But we didn't create a GitHub object. So I will go to lib-lucia-oauth.ts. So you can see that we are creating a new object with our client ID and client script. So we will do the same thing for GitHub. And this GitHub class comes from Arctic again. And as you can see, it expects two or three arguments. One of them client ID, client secret, and options redirect URI. So we will give process.env, GitHub client ID, and client secret. Then I will also give options and redirect URI. And it will be this. Once user accept our consent screen, it will be redirected to this route where we will create this API route in a bit. Perfect. So we are exporting it here so that we can use it in the app.actions. And this function expects a state and an options object. It gets scopes. And this was valid for Google. So let's check GitHub scopes. You see that we have a list of scopes that we can enter, and we will enter this one, user colon email, like this. And this will generate a URL for us. We return this URL as in the data. After getting a success here, we redirect user into that page. I will go to here and click on this, and it says this page couldn't be found. And it says redirect URI mismatch. Okay, let's check API OAuth GitHub. Okay, here I made a mistake. It should be OAuth callback URL. I have changed it to OAuth and save changes. Now I will try it again. Now, as you can see, we have a consent screen and it says the GitHub out wants to access your email address. Once I authorize this app, it will redirect me to localhost 3000/api/oauth/github. But we don't have this yet. Let me click it actually. So you can see that it redirect me with a state and a code. And now I will go to my API and oauth. As you can see, we have a Google folder. I will copy this and change it to GitHub. And we have a root here. And let's change it. So first of all, we don't have a type yet. I will remove it. And we are getting search params, code and state. Great. And we don't have code verifier. We have a state in the cookie. We don't check for code verifier anymore. Let me remove these. Great. So we are checking if the state in our cookie and the state we get from URL is matching. If they do not, we return. And here we are getting some information from Google, but we will use GitHub now. And it has also a function for validating authorization code, and it expects a code. As you can see, we will pass our code and it returns only access token rather than returning refresh token and expire that as Google do. And I will say GitHub res. And here after we get the access token, we are fetching user information with this access token. We can use this API. And we are appending our access token into headers as Beaver authorization. I will say GitHub data, and this will be GitHub res as any for now, but we should fix this one. Here I will use GitHub data.id, and we don't need those. Okay, actually, let me log this GitHub data so that we can see what we have. I will go back, click on sign in with GitHub. And we will see our GitHub data here. So we have an ID. As you can see, we don't have an email for my profile. It's because I make my email private in GitHub. So that's why we should change schema, because we said email cannot be null, but now we see that there may not be an email of that user. I will type drizzle kit generate pg. And I will say push PG. So changes are applied. Perfect. Then we don't need to have an email to create a user table from now on. I will go back to my root. Here I can remove this email. This is where we create a user. And we will have GitHub data ID. And let's see what we have as name. What is the field? Okay, it is a name. I can use this one. For the picture, we have avatar URL, so we can use that one like this. Great, then we are just checking here. And also we create a record in our OAuth account table, but we don't have expires yet. Provider will be GitHub. Provider user ID will be GitHub data that ID, user ID is same, and we don't have a refresh token as well. And that seems fine, but it gives some error as you can see. I will go to my schema here and we'll check. So refresh token text expires at null, but it may be null as GitHub doesn't return. I will generate a migration again and push changes are applied. Great. And now everything seems fine. And we can use generate ID from Lucia here to generate an ID. It doesn't matter if you give GitHub data ID here as well. And this was for when there is no user. We have created a user. We have created a record in the OAuth table. What if is there user already? We will need to update the table, but we don't have expires at and refresh token. So we will only refresh the access token here. And this will be GitHub data. Lastly, we just create a session using Lucia, as you can see. Create a session cookie and set it. And then we also remove the state from cookies. We don't have code verifier, so we can remove this part. And lastly, we just redirect user to our dashboard. Everything should be fine right now. And now I'm logged in. Perfect. Thank you for watching. If you learned something new in this video about please consider subscribing to my channel, and if you like the video you can drop a like, of course, and if you have any questions just drop a comment. I will answer as soon as possible. I know this video was super fast, but we have already done this job in the previous video, the one we have implemented Google. I have already talked about step by step, so if you have some questions you can watch this. And but this was pretty easy. So the idea was actually, let me go to my, yeah, the idea is same for all social media. So these are the steps how we can create a social login. First, we create an application inside the platform we are planning to use. In our case, it was GitHub. And we have grabbed our client ID and client secret here and put it in ENV file. Then we have created our authorization URL and send user to there. And then we just wait for the user to accept it. And once it accepts, the platform returns user to us with some information here. And we check if this information valid and we get user's access token. With this access token, we fetch user's personal information such as email, name, ID. Then we are just saving them into DB. Then we create a session for the user. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye bye.